Okay, Lynn, this is your transmission. We've got it apart, and here's the metal that we saw in the pan. We knew it was coming apart, and you can see that it's pretty bad. And what it's actually done is plugged up the filter here, and it starved the transmission for fluid, and it's burned up the clutches. Is what it's done. It's you can see that that should be silver, and it's all turned blue from the heat. And when it starved for fluid, the planetaries here, these spin on needle bearings, and because they're not, they didn't get lubricated. I'll see if I can get this for you here. Let's see. Zoom in there. You can see it. See that? How that pin, this gear, just wallowing around. And this is where all that metal was coming from. It's out of the planetaries. This engages that, and it's wore completely out. Front one is wore out as well, and it's going to need a complete new gear train in it. And that metal has got into the torque converter and contaminated this torque converter. It shares the same fluid as the transmission. It takes the place of a clutch if you had a stick shift. It's between the transmission and the engine. But anyway, what it's going to take to fix this is going to be a complete rebuild. It's going to have all new clutches, band, also these pistons, molded pistons. It's going to have upgraded molded pistons in it. And we're going to obviously replace the filter. There's also in the valve body, which is the brain of the transmission, we're going to have to replace the electronics here. This has solenoids, and that's an electronics package that will be on your estimate that's attached, but this will have a 5-year, 100,000 mile warranty on it. I haven't written the estimate, but I know it's going to be pricey because this gear train is real pricey, and so is the rebuild kit. But it'll have 5-year, 100,000 mile warranty. Also, we need to flush the transmission cooler system because it's contaminated with that same metal as well, and I'll show you how we do that with a hot flush machine. That's a real good machine because a lot of places will replace the cooler, but we can save you money by not doing that. So there you have it. You could reply to this email or just simply give us a call. Either way, Lynn, thanks for your business. Okay, this is our hot flush machine, and it's not hooked up to your car, but it's going to be, and this is just an example to show you how it works. As you can see on the side here, the hot flush is hooked up to shop air pressure. Runs over there to the lift, and then these hoses are hooked to the vehicle. And what happens is this runs heated transmission fluid through the transmission cooler system in the vehicle. And what it does is this heated fluid gets up to about 190 degrees. Right now it's only at about 179 degrees, but it'll get up to 190. And we usually set the timer for 3 hours. This one is currently set for 1 hour. We'll bump this up. But 3 hours is a normal time that we run it. And it runs heated fluid for 3 seconds, and then for half a second, it blasts 150 pounds of shop air the opposite way. And that's the pulsation that you see and hear. And right now, this one, it'll get up to about 60 pounds. Right now it's running about 20 pounds, but it'll get up here to 50 or 60 pounds. And then it also measures volume here. Right now this is flowing about 5 gallons a minute is what that's flowing. I don't know if you see that with the glare on it or not. But let's see if I get a better shot of that. Where that orange line is, that's right at 5 gallons a minute. And it's heated fluid, and it gets all that metal and clutch debris out. And this is a state-of-the-art machine. I mean, it just doesn't get any better than that. But that's the hot flush machine, and that's what's going to be hooked up to your car to get all that contamination out of the cooler.